Hello anatomy friends, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing one of the structural classifications of joints, which are the fibrous joints. So we will talk through what makes a fibrous joint, so what is the connective tissue that's present, and what are the different types of fibrous joints. So we'll give a few examples of each, if that's possible. So fibrous joints are within that structural classification of a joint where bones are connected by a solid sheet of connective tissue. So what I mean by that is, say this is a bone, and this is a bone. There will be a completely solid sheet, or as close to solid as possible, of connective tissue that is actually what is connecting the bones. It does not have that space in between like you'll have in a synovial joint. So in the case of fibrous joints, which is what we're talking about here, the connective tissue that we're talking about is dense irregular connective tissue. And how much of that dense irregular connective tissue is between the bone differs between the different types of fibrous joints. Sometimes it can be really short. Sometimes you can have longer sheets of connective tissue. So let's talk through these three types of fibrous joints that we have named here. The first type, and my personal favorite, is the suture. And suture means seam, which you can see here. A suture does kind of look like a seam between the two bones. And you only have sutures between the bones of the skull. And so you'll have sutures nowhere else in the body, so only related to between bones of the skull. And the amount of fibrous tissue is pretty short between the two bones, and this fibrous tissue is specifically called a sutural ligament, so this would be an example of an intrinsic ligament. The fact that the ligaments are relatively short is indicative of the fact that there is very little movement allowed at these joints. In fact, in juveniles, these joints are very slightly movable, so not much movement, and it will become these joints will become increasingly immovable with age. All right. In fact, these would be labeled as synarthrosis. And these can actually, in individuals of advanced age and sometimes younger, the fibrous connective tissue can be entirely replaced with bone, becoming what we call a bony joint or synostosis. So instead of having a sutural ligament, this would all be completely replaced by bone, and at that point, that would be called a synostosis. So not every single joint in an adult will do this, or not every single suture in an adult will do this with advanced age, but many do. Okay, so those are sutures. The second type of fibrous joint is a gomphosis, which is a super awesome name. And this isn't a unique one because it isn't between a bone and bone. It is actually between a tooth and bone. So I have peg and socket here because it's like a peg. So that peg would be the tooth sitting in a socket, and the socket would be that bony socket. So here is the bone, and that tooth sits right in there. Sometimes you will see gomphoses categorized in the next category we're going to talk about, or the syndesmoses. We're going to keep it separate for our purposes because I think it's unique enough to have its own category. The amount of connective tissue is a little bit longer than what you see in some sutures, and instead of the sutural ligament, these intrinsic ligaments that connect the bone to the tooth are referred to as the periodontal ligament, or the PDL. Lastly, and the most movable, but still would be in the amphiarthrotic category, so certainly not freely movable, these are not synovial joints, you will have the category of a syndesmosis, or syndesmoses if you're talking plural. So this little bit of movement is allowable because of the longer or more fibrous connective tissue between the bones. And the most notable type of syndesmosis is an interosseous membrane, which sometimes the interosseous membrane is put into its own category of fibrous joints, but we are going to include them within the syndesmoses. These will connect the diaphyses of the forearm bones when we're talking about an interosseous membrane. So between the radius and the ulna, which we can see in this image here, so this sheet right here is going to be that interosseous membrane joint, so this whole complex. And you'll also have an interosseous membrane for between the diaphyses of the leg bones, the fibula and tibia. You will have other syndesmoses in the body, like on the distal ends of the tibia and the fibula, around the epiphyseal portions there. And so these are the three categories of fibrous joints. So let's do a quick recall question. Question is, the interosseous membrane between the tibia and the fibula is an example of which type of fibrous joint? Is it a gomphosis, a suture, or a syndesmosis? Pause the video if you need to, but when you are ready, let's discuss how C, or syndesmosis, is the correct answer. Recall that syndesmoses have comparatively longer sheets of fibrous connective tissue between the bones, and that is definitely the case for the interosseous membrane. Also, just as a reminder, sometimes you see the interosseous membrane as its own category of fibrous joints, but I think it fits quite well with the syndesmoses, so that's how we're categorizing it for our purposes in this course. The suture isn't correct because these are only found in the skull or between the bones of the skull. As are gomphoses, these are only between teeth and bone, so also associated with the skull. All right, please make sure to review these materials and reach out with any questions you may have. Thank you for your time and attention.